In a debate over conservation versus cruelty, the life of a second giraffe is now on the line. Another Danish zoo may put down the animal to make way for, quote, genetically more valuable giraffes. And that means a zoo wants to bring in a female, mate her with a male, leaving the second male out in the cold. The zoologist at the zoo says, quote, we will, of course, try to place him in a suitable zoo, but if that is not possible, we might have to euthanize him. And the unlucky giraffe's name is Marius. And a warning now, this is a warning, the pictures you're about to see are very graphic. Marius is also the name of the giraffe killed Sunday by a different zoo in Denmark for similar reasons. Marius one, was then fed to the lions with children watching, creating an international outcry. So with me now is Tom Stauff. He is a chief operating officer at the Columbus Zoo. You know, Tom, it is really an horrific story. Reuters is reporting this, that euthanizing has been ongoing in the Danish zoo world. I mean, what's your reaction when you hear about that?
This is such a tragedy. And when I hear and I read the story, it's all about planning. And, you know, we're so proud at the Columbus Zoo and Aquarium that we have partners throughout the AZA, which is the Association of Zoos and Aquariums. We have over 200 that we work together, not only working through AZA zoos, but also other affiliations that have the same standards of care. So when we read this story about what happened in Copenhagen, and now we're moving on to another story similar to this, we beg for them to plan and work with their networks, because there are so many other fantastic facilities out there that can help these animals.
Coincidentally, you know, that male giraffe, both of them were named Marius. So what are the chances of that? But here's the question. Any chance that a U.S. zoo may step in to help this giraffe?
Oh, there's no question about it. There are many zoos that would help. Here at the Columbus Zoo, we also have a great partnership with the Wilds. We have 10,000 acres where we could clearly take this giraffe. But I would encourage the organization EAZA, which is the European Association for Zoos and Aquariums. They work together, and it's all about planning. It's very important that we realize that the animals that we have in our care, they're ambassadors, and they're giving us an opportunity to tell a story about these beautiful animals, where they come from, and how we can protect them. It's about conservation success, and in order for us to work together, it's all about working throughout not only the United States, but also all of our friends through the world.
Can you talk to me more about what happens in the U.S. when a zoo gets too many animals, and how do American zoos prevent against inbreeding?
Sure, absolutely. We have an organization, it's the Population Management Center. It's located in the United States, and it works throughout all of the zoos, working with our Species Survival Program, or SSP. We have over 500 species that are working through this SSP, and we all work together. It doesn't matter if you're located in New York, Ohio, or California. We all work together to make sure that all of our animals are paired appropriately and that they have homes. As they breed, they can move to different facilities. We always prepare, always plan to make sure that every person has an opportunity to see these beautiful species that we have in our care.
Tom Stauff, thank you so much. We appreciate you joining us on CNN.